In the case of partnership accounts, when a new partner is admitted into the partnership firm, there are certain adjustments to be made in the books of accounts. Now, partnership accounts alli admission na sandarbhadalli kelavondu badalavanegalannu tarbekagutade. One is a revaluation of assets, then goodwill treatment. And in some cases, the partners also will agree to adjust their capital. ಕೆಲವೊಂದು ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಅಡ್ಜಸ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಇರ್ತದೆ. ಸೊ ಅದನ್ನು ಹೇಗೆ ಮಾಡೋದು ಅನ್ನೋದನ್ನು ಈ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಳಿಕೊಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೇನೆ. ಸೊ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ದ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಅಡ್ಜಸ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್. ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ದೆರ್ ಆರ್ ಟೂ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ನರ್ಸ್ ಸಿ ಅಂಡ್ ಡಿ. ದೇ ಆರ್ ಶೇರಿಂಗ್ ದ ಪ್ರಾಫಿಟ್ಸ್. ದೇ ವರ್ ಶೇರಿಂಗ್ ದ ಪ್ರಾಫಿಟ್ಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲಿ. ಸೊ ಓಲ್ಡ್ ಪ್ರಾಫಿಟ್ ಶೇರಿಂಗ್ ರೇಷಿಯೋ ವಾಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಯು ಓಕೆ ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಶನ್ ಟು ರಿವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ದ ಅಸೆಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಲಯಬಿಲಿಟೀಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ the capital will have to be adjusted. Finally, the capital will have to be adjusted and it has to be in the ratio of profit sharing ratio, that is new profit sharing ratio. Now next is preparation of revaluation account. Now preparation of revaluation account will be very easy if you understand what I have here on the table. ಇಲ್ಲಿರುವ ವಿಷಯವನ್ನು ನೀವು ಸರಿಯಾಗಿ ಅರ್ಥ ಮಾಡಿದರೆ ರಿವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂಯೇಷನ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ಮಾಡುವುದು ಬಹಳ ಸುಲಭ. ನೌ ಒನ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್, ರಿವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂಯೇಷನ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ಐದರ್ ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಡೆಬಿಟೆಡ್ ಆರ್ ಕ್ರೆಡಿಟೆಡ್. ಸೊ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ವೆನ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಡೆಬಿಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ವೆನ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಕ್ರೆಡಿಟ್ ಇಟ್. ಅದನ್ನು ಯಾವಾಗ ಡೆಬಿಟ್ ಮಾಡುವುದು ಅಥವಾ ಯಾವಾಗ ಕ್ರೆಡಿಟ್ ಮಾಡುವುದು ಎನ್ನುವುದನ್ನು ಅರ್ಥ ಮಾಡಿದರೆ ರಿವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂಯೇಷನ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ಮಾಡುವುದು ಬಹಳ ಸುಲಭ. ಸೊ revaluation account is a nominal account. If there is profit on revaluation, you have to credit it. And if there is loss on revaluation, it has to be debited. Because it goes by the nominal account rule prakara alli now madbekagutade. Debit all expenses and losses, credit all incomes and gains. So, you understand that here. When there is profit on revaluation, you have to credit this to revaluation account. Andre revaluation account idu credit side alli baruttave aa entry annu. Ade reethi alli loss bandidre adannu revaluation account idu debit side alli baruttave. Now the question is, when you will have profit on revaluation? Now generally take any asset for that matter. Okay, if there is an increase in the value of asset, yavadadru ond asset value hechagidre, okay, adu yavaglu namge adrinda profit bartade. So there is profit when there is increase in the value of asset. Okay, so illi ond 10000 iruva asset 12000 ke adra value hechagidre, that 2000 is the profit for the business, right? Yes. So next is, when there is a decline in the value of liability, when the liability value kadime agidru, okay, now iga for example nee ond 12000 record madidiri adre kodlikirudu kevala 5000, okay, so neevu kadime liability kodbekagutade. So there is profit even in this case. And when there is an unrecorded asset, when the asset record madlilla, when you bring this into account books alli bariyuva sandarbhadalli, there is profit on revaluation. So there will be profit on revaluation when there is increase in the asset value, decrease in the liability value, and when there is an unrecorded asset to be brought into account. All these three cases you will have profit on revaluation. You need to credit this to revaluation account. Now next is, ಯಾವ ಸಂದರ್ಭದಲ್ಲಿ ನಮಗೆ ಲಾಸ್ ಆನ್ ರಿವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂಯೇಷನ್ ಬರ್ತದೆ? ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್, ಇಫ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಲಯಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಫ್ ದ ಲಯಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸಸ್, ಓಕೆ, ಅಲ್ಲಿ 10000 ಅಂತ ಬರೆದಿದ್ದೀರಿ, ನೀವು 12000 ನಿಮಗೆ ಕೊಡಲಿಕ್ಕಿದ್ರೆ, ಓಕೆ, ದರ್ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಲಯಬಿಲಿಟಿ, ಓಕೆ, ಅಡಿಷನಲ್ ಲಯಬಿಲಿಟಿ, ಸೊ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ರಿಸಲ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಲಾಸ್. ಸಿಮಿಲರ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಎಸೆಟ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಆಗಿದ್ರೆ, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದರ್ ಇಸ್ ಡಿಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಆಫ್ ಎಸೆಟ್, okay, then also there will be loss. And if you have to record one liability which was not there in the books, ondu hosathondu liability annu record maduva sandarbhadallo alli loss on revaluation bartade, you need to debit revaluation account. Ee ella sandarbhadalli revaluation account annu debit martteve. Now we will now for preparing the revaluation account, first we will understand what is there in the problem. Now it is given that E is admitted into the firm on the following terms. So first, to write off bad debts amounting to 5500. Now bad debt is the debt which cannot be recovered. Okay, debt adannu recovery madlikke sadhya illa. So it is included in this debtors 1,41,500. In that, this 5,500 include agide. Adre ee debt recovery madlikke sadhya illada karana naavu adannu write off madbeku. Okay, you have to reduce this debtors of 5,500 of debtors to be written off. So now we find that the asset, there is decline. Okay, asset value has reduced. Debtor andre asset, a value reduce agide. So when asset, there is decrease in the value of asset, that is loss for the business. Okay, so you are going to revalue the asset. When there is decrease in the value of asset, it is a loss for the business. So the total amount to be written off 5,500, that is a loss for the business, we have to write it on the debit side. Now next is to write down the furniture by 10%. Now furniture is also asset. Okay, now it has to be reduced by 10%, means it is a loss for the business. So you have to record it on the debit side of the revaluation account. Amount is to be calculated as 7,500 into 10%. Into 10%, that will be 750. Okay. Now next is stock. It has to be depreciated. Depreciate means again you need to reduce the stock. Stock kannu kadime madlike helta idare. Asset value kadime adre adli namge loss bartade. Okay. It is once again loss. So it is to be reduced by. Okay. So this same amount 5,000 has to be taken in the revaluation account. When they use the word by 5,000, so the total loss is 5,000, you take that amount, okay, when this word by is used. Now next is to provide for outstanding legal charges. Now you do not have this outstanding legal charges. Outstanding legal charges andre business ee hanavannu kodlike unto. Okay, legal charges that has to be paid. It is due from the business. Okay, so it is a liability for the business, but it is not recorded in the balance sheet. Balance sheet alli record madlilla. So this is unrecorded liability. Now you have to bring this into account. Ivaga books ge now barebekagutade. So when you record an unrecorded liability, it is a loss for the business. Iga tanaka illaddu liability annu neevu record martta iddiri. So loss for the business. Total amount is 4,750. The total amount is a loss for the business. So you have to debit this to the revaluation account. Okay. Now next is on the credit side, okay, of the revaluation account, you do not have any item. That is, whatever the item that you have, it results in loss. Okay, yella vishayagalinda namge loss siktade, loss on revaluation, and we have recorded it on the debit side. So we do not have any entry on the, we do not have any profit on revaluation. Now you have to balance this account. Okay, so the total of the debit side is 16,000. When you add 5,500, 750, 5,000, 4,750, you will get 16,000 total. So that is the total for the revaluation account, and it is loss. Okay, because you do not have any item on the credit side. Now this will have to be given to the old partners. Okay, old partner ge idanu hanchi kodbekagutade. The 16,000 is the loss on revaluation. So the total loss on revaluation will have to be distributed to the old partner. In what ratio? It is always distributed in their old profit sharing ratio. So the new partner will not get a share in this. Idralli avanige share sigudilla. It belongs to the old partner. Okay. So you are doing it at the time of admission. Idralli new partner ge yavude share kodabardu. So when you divide it, it is 8,000 for each partner. They will get 8,000. Okay. And the total is, total we have 16,000. Now this is the revaluation account, and we found that the total loss on revaluation is 16,000. Okay. Now next is preparation of capital account. For this we have to understand the goodwill treatment. Illi problem alli kottidare, he has to introduce 50,000 for goodwill and 2 lakh for his capital. Okay, for a fifth share. ಸೊ ಗುಡ್ ವಿಲ್ ಟ್ರೀಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಹೀ ಬ್ರಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಫಾರ್ ಗುಡ್ ವಿಲ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ಗುಡ್ ವಿಲ್ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಶೀಟಲ್ಲಿ ಕೊಡಲಿಲ್ಲ ಸೊ ಹೌ ಡು ವಿ ಪಾಸ್ ದ ಜರ್ನಲ್ ಎಂಟ್ರಿ ಫಾರ್ ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಬ್ರಾಟ್ ಇನ್ ಆಸ್ ಗುಡ್ ವಿಲ್ ಗುಡ್ ವಿಲ್ ಅನ್ನು ಹಣದ ರೂಪದಲ್ಲಿ ತರ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ ಸೊ ಹೇಗೆ ನಾವು ಎಂಟ್ರಿ ಪಾಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೇವೆ ನೋ ವೆನ್ ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಇಸ್ ಬ್ರಾಟ್ ಇನ್ ಹಣ ತರುವಾಗ ದ ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ದ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಡೆಬಿಟೆಡ್ ಓಕೆ ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ನೌ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಕ್ರೆಡಿಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ಡೆಟರ್ ಟು ಈಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ದ ಟೋಟಲ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಗುಡ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬ್ರಾಟ್ ಇನ್ ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ 50,000 ಆ ನಂತರ ಈ ಗುಡ್ ವಿಲ್ ಅನ್ನು ಹಣದ ರೂಪದಲ್ಲಿ ತರುವ ಉದ್ದೇಶ ಏನಂದ್ರೆ ದ ನ್ಯೂ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ನರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಗಿವ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದ ಓಲ್ಡ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ನರ್ ಓಕೆ ಅವನು ಬೆನಿಫಿಟ್ ಕೊಡಬೇಕು ಹಿ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಟು ಗಿವ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದ ಓಲ್ಡ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ನರ್ ಸೊ ಟು ಡೂ ದಟ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಡೆಬಿಟ್ ನ್ಯೂ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ನರ್ಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಕ್ರೆಡಿಟ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಗಿವನ್ ಟು ದ ಓಲ್ಡ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ನರ್ಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ಸೊ ದ ಎಂಟ್ರಿ ಈಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ಡೆಟರ್ ಟು ಸೀಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ಟು ಡೀಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಕ್ರೆಡಿಟ್ ಓಲ್ಡ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ನರ್ಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ಸೊ ಓಲ್ಡ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ನರ್ನ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ಹೆಚ್ಚಾಗ್ತದೆ ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ದ ಬೆನಿಫಿಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಹೂ ವಿಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಗಿವ್ ದಿಸ್ ಬೆನಿಫಿಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ನ್ಯೂ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ನರ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇ ನೌ ದ ಟೋಟಲ್ 50,000 ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ದ ಓಲ್ಡ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ನರ್ ಇನ್ ದೇರ್ ಸ್ಯಾಕ್ರಿಫೈಸ್ ರೇಷಿಯೋ ನೌ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ವಿ ಡು ನಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎನಿ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಶನ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಸ್ಯಾಕ್ರಿಫೈಸ್ ರೇಷಿಯೋ ಬಟ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದ ಓಲ್ಡ್ ಪ್ರಾಫಿಟ್ ಶೇರಿಂಗ್ ರೇಷಿಯೋ ವಿಚ್ ಈಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ವಿ ನೋ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ದ ನ್ಯೂ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ನರ್ ಶೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಫಿಫ್ತ್ ಒನ್ ಫಿಫ್ತ್ ಓಕೆ 1/5 ಸೊ ವೆನ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ದಿಸ್ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಶನ್ ಯುವರ್ ಸ್ಯಾಕ್ರಿಫೈಸ್ ರೇಷಿಯೋ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಓಲ್ಡ್ ಪ್ರಾಫಿಟ್ ಶೇರಿಂಗ್ ರೇಷಿಯೋ ಸೊ ಈ ಸ್ಯಾಕ್ರಿಫೈಸ್ ರೇಷಿಯೋದಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಡಿವೈಡ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೇವೆ ಸ್ಯಾಕ್ರಿಫೈಸ್ ರೇಷಿಯೋ ಈ ಕೇಸಲ್ಲಿ ಓಲ್ಡ್ ಪ್ರಾಫಿಟ್ ಶೇರಿಂಗ್ ರೇಷಿಯೋಗೆ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಇರ್ತದೆ ಸೊ ದ ಸ್ಯಾಕ್ರಿಫೈಸ್ ರೇಷಿಯೋ ಈಸ್ 1:1 ಓಕೆ ಸ್ಯಾಕ್ರಿಫೈಸ್ ರೇಷಿಯೋ ಈಸ್ 1:1 ಓಕೆ ಇನ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಡಿವೈಡ್ ನೌ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಅಡ್ಜಸ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಸೊ ಫಾರ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಒನ್ಸ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ದ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಟು ಅಡ್ಜಸ್ಟ್ ದ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಡಿ ಓಕೆ ಅಕಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದ ನ್ಯೂ ಪ್ರಾಫಿಟ್ ಶೇರಿಂಗ್ ರೇಷಿಯೋ ಬೇಸ್ಡ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಇ ಥ್ರೂ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ನೌ ಹೌ ಡು ವಿ ಡೂ ದಿಸ್ ನೌ ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಅಡ್ಜಸ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಅಡ್ಮಿಷನ್ ಆಗುವ ಸಂದರ್ಭದಲ್ಲಿ ಕೆಲವೊಮ್ಮೆ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ನರ್ಸ್ ಅಗ್ರಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಳ್ತಾರೆ ಏನಂತ ಅಂದರೆ ಅವರ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ಸ್ ನ್ಯೂ ಪ್ರಾಫಿಟ್ ಶೇರಿಂಗ್ ರೇಷಿಯೋದ ಪ್ರಕಾರ ಇರಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಸೊ ದೇ ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದೇರ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಇನ್ ಪ್ರಪೋರ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದೇರ್ ನ್ಯೂ ಪ್ರಾಫಿಟ್ ಶೇರಿಂಗ್ ರೇಷಿಯೋ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ನ್ಯೂ ಪ್ರಾಫಿಟ್ ಶೇರಿಂಗ್ ರೇಷಿಯೋ 1:1 ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಇದ್ದರೆ ದ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಈಚ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ನರ್ ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಕೇಸ್ ನೌ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಡು ನಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಇನ್ ದ ನ್ಯೂ ಪ್ರಾಫಿಟ್ ಶೇರಿಂಗ್ ರೇಷಿಯೋ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ದ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಫೈನಲಿ ದ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಅಕಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದ ನ್ಯೂ ಪ್ರಾಫಿಟ್ ಶೇರಿಂಗ್ ರೇಷಿಯೋ ಫೈನಲ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸಸ್ ನ್ಯೂ ಪ್ರಾಫಿಟ್ ಶೇರಿಂಗ್ ರೇಷಿಯೋದಲ್ಲಿ ಇರುವ ಹಾಗೆ ನೀವು ನೋಡಿಕೊಳ್ಬೇಕಾಗ್ತದೆ ಸೊ ಹೌ ಡು ವಿ ಡೂ ದಿಸ್ ಓಕೆ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್ ವಿ ನೀಡ್ ದ ನ್ಯೂ ಪ್ರಾಫಿಟ್ ಶೇರಿಂಗ್ ರೇಷಿಯೋ ನ್ಯೂ ಪ್ರಾಫಿಟ್ ಶೇರಿಂಗ್ ರೇಷಿಯೋ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಕೊಡಲಿಲ್ಲ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಸೊ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ದ ನ್ಯೂ ಪ್ರಾಫಿಟ್ ಶೇರಿಂಗ್ ರೇಷಿಯೋ ನೌ ಹೌ ಡು ವಿ ಡೂ ದಿಸ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದ ಶೇರ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ನ್ಯೂ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ನರ್ ಸೊ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಟೇಕ್ ದ ಟೋಟಲ್ ಪ್ರಾಫಿಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಫರ್ಮ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಟೇಕನ್ ಆಸ್ 1 ಸೊ ಔಟ್ ಆಫ್ 1 ಯು ಆರ್ ಗಿವಿಂಗ್ 1/5 ಅವನಿಗೆ 1/5 ಕೊಡ್ತೀರಿ ಸೊ ಎಷ್ಟು ಉಳೀತು ಅಂತ ನಾವು ನೋಡಬೇಕು 1-1/5 ದಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಗಿವ್ ಯು 4/5 ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ವೆನ್ ಯು ಡಿಡಕ್ಟ್ ದ ಫ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಯು ಗೆಟ್ 4/5 ದಿಸ್ 4/5 ಅಂದರೆ ಇದು ಇರುವಂತಹ ಓಲ್ಡ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ನರ್ಗೆ ಉಳಿದಂತಹ ಶೇರ್ ಇದು ಸೊ ಈ 4/5 ಅನ್ನು ಓಲ್ಡ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ನರ್ನ ನಡುವೆ ನಾವು ಹಂಚಿಕೊಳ್ಬೇಕಾಗ್ತದೆ ಸೊ ರಿಮೈನಿಂಗ್ ಶೇರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಶೇರ್ಡ್ ಈಕ್ವಲಿ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ಸಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಡಿ ಇಬ್ಬರ ನಡುವೆ ನಾವು ಈ 4/5 ಅನ್ನು ಹಂಚಬೇಕು ಸೊ ಔಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ರಿಮೈನಿಂಗ್ ಶೇರ್ ವಾಟ್ ಸಿ ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವಾಟ್ ಡಿ ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಸಿ ನೌ ಸಿ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಓಲ್ಡ್ ಪ್ರಾಫಿಟ್ ಶೇರಿಂಗ್ ಇಸ್ 1:1 ಸೊ ಹಾಫ್ ಆಫ್ 4/5 ವಿಲ್ ಗೋ ಟು ಸಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಅನದರ್ ಹಾಫ್ ಆಫ್ 4/5 ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಅರ್ಧ ಡಿಗೆ ಕೊಡಬೇಕಾಗ್ತದೆ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹೌ ಡು ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಹಾಫ್ ಇಂಟು 4/5 ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ 4/10 ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ 2/5 ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಡಿ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಗೆಟ್ಸ್ 2/5 ದ ಸೇಮ್ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಷನ್ Now the new profit sharing ratio of all the partners in the new firm, okay, hosa samsthayalli eshtu avara new profit sharing ratio irthade. It is 2/5 is to 2/5 is to 1/5. This 1/5 is the share of the new partner. Now the capital also should be according to their new profit sharing ratio. So how do we do this? It is given that in the problem, based on the capital of E, okay, andre new partner idu capital annu neevu adharavagi tegedukondo neevu ella partners idu capitals annu calculate maadbeku. So E's capital will have to be taken as the base, okay, that is 2 lakh, and then we have to calculate the capital of all the partners, ella partner idu calculate maadbeku. So how do we do this? See, for 1/5 share he brings in 2 lakh capital. 1/5 share ge 2 lakh capital contribute martane. Hagidre idi firm idu total capital eshtu aagtade. So he brings in 2 lakh for 1/5 share, right? So the total profit of the firm is 1. Okay, so what is the total capital of the firm? When you do this cross multiplication, okay, we get this answer: 2 lakh into 1 divided by 1/5. And we get a reciprocal here, which is 2 lakh into 5/1 bartade. So the answer is 10 lakhs. Okay. What is this 10 lakh? 10 lakh is the total capital of the firm. Okay. So one sala new total capital annu kandu hididre, new sulabhavagi ellara capitals annu new kandu hidibodu. So you can easily calculate the capital of each partner. So out of 10 lakh, okay, you know that the capital should be according to the new profit sharing ratio. Out of 10 lakh, 2/5 is C's capital. Once again, 2/5 of 10 lakh is D's capital, and E's will be 1/5 of 10 lakh. So C's capital for 2/5 share, how much is to we need to have? Okay, so 10 lakh into 2/5, that will give you 4 lakh. D is also, it is 4 lakh, okay, and E is, you have it, okay, because based on E is only we have calculated the capital of other two partners. So idannu mattomme neevu calculate maado agathilla, it is 2 lakh. Now add it, 4 lakh plus 4 lakh plus 2 lakh, total 10 lakh. So what did we do? Total 10 lakh is divided in the ratio of 2:1, okay. That is their new profit sharing ratio. Now next is the preparation of capital accounts. We have here 3 partners. All the 3 partners capital account will be prepared in the same table in a columnar form. Andre ee table alli 3 capital account annu ottige maartta iddeve columnar form alli. So we have to see what is there in the problem. The opening balance of capital is C and D, it is 1,50,000. So I have recorded it on the credit side because there is a credit balance in the capital account. It is 1,50,000. Nantra general reserve, andre undistributed profit antasa heltave, accumulated profit antasa heltave. Okay, illi credit balance irthade, liability side alli kottantaha ella account alli credit balance irthade. So general reserve alli sa credit balance untu. This will be distributed among the old partner. Okay, so we have only 2 old partner. It is 50,000 is divided between the old partner in their profit sharing ratio, which is 1:1. Okay, so we get 25,000 and 25,000. Now next is revaluation account. We have already prepared the revaluation account, and in that the final loss is 16,000, which is divided between the 2 old partner. Entry is capital account debtor to revaluation account. So when we do the posting, revaluation account illi bariyuvaga, it is capital account, partners capital account, only old partners capital account debtor to revaluation account. Amount is 8,000 for each partner. Okay. Now next is goodwill treatment. I have already explained this. Now cash is brought in by the new partner. Entry is cash account debtor to E's capital account. When we do the posting, idana capital account alli bariyuvaga, it is is capital account is credited, right? So we have to record it on the credit side as buy. Okay, we have to record it on the credit side as buy cash account. So this will be recorded in is account because it is credited to is capital account. Amount is, he brings in 50,000 as goodwill. Now next entry is E's capital account debtor to C's capital account and to D's capital account. Okay, so here you have to be careful while posting the entry to the capital account. So I will explain this. Now take that first you have E's capital account. All the three capital accounts are there in this entry. Ella more capital account kuda illi unto. Adanu avaravara capital account ige now posting maadbekagutade. So first entry is you are writing it in is capital account. Iga is capital account alli hege bariyutha anta nodwa. Is capital account is debited, right? So you have to write it on the debit side. Debit side alli baruttave. Hege anta baruttave. Is capital account debtor to, it is C's capital account. Okay, C's capital account. So is capital account to C's capital account. Now you are writing it in is capital account alli baruta iddiri. Is capital account annu debit maadidiri. So ha karanadinda is column alli barbeku. Amount barebekadaddu 25,000. Next, once again, is capital account to D's capital account. So once again, is capital account is debited. How do you do the posting? To, right? So to D's capital account. D's capital account entry is, it is 25,000. Okay, 25,000. So you have done the posting to E's capital account. E's capital account alli bartha itu. Iga C's capital account alli hege posting madudu. C's capital account ili nodidre adu credit agide. So new credit side alli barebekagutade adannu. Okay, so you have to write it on the credit side. C's capital account is credited by E's capital account. Pariyuvaga it is by E's capital account. E's capital account amount is 25,000. So ivaga neevu bardaddu C's account alli, C's capital account alli. So C the column alli 25,000 bartade. Next, iga nanu posting D's capital account alli hege madod anta helta iddene. So D's capital account nodidre ee journal entry alli adu credit maadideve, right? So credit side alli barebeku. So D's capital account is credited by E's capital account. By E's capital account. Okay, so iga neevu bardaddu D's capital account alli. So D column alli nanu hakta iddene illi, it is 25,000. Okay, so ee riti ee entry annu capital account ge now posting martteve. Now next is we have made all the entries. Once again, E has contributed capital, which is 2 lakh. 2 lakh capital contribution unto. So adanu ee account alli posting maadbeku. It is, entry is cash account debtor to E's capital account. So E's capital account is credited by cash account. Capital contribution. Entry in E's column, it is 2 lakh. Okay, 2 lakh. Now there is capital adjustment. Okay, now I will explain the capital adjustment. We have recorded all the important entries in the capital account. Iga capital adjustment andre the final balance in their capital account is given. It is we have already calculated 4 lakh in C's capital alli final balance irbeku. D's capital alli 4 lakh irbeku. E's capital alli 2 lakh irbeku. So this is the closing balance in the capital account. Capital account is the closing balance ee riti irbeku. Okay, so closing balance means there will be a credit balance in capital account. Credit side hech irthade. So closing balance we have to write it first. Modle now closing balance bardu biduva. To balance carried down, okay, to balance carried down amount, we already know this 4 lakh. Next column also it is 4 lakh and next column it is 2 lakh. So what we found is the total capital 10 lakhsha irbeku. 10 lakshavannu 2:2:1 new profit sharing ratio dali divide maadi hakuvaga capital ishtu irbeku anta gottaitu. So this is the closing balance in their capital account. Now what we have to do with the balance, okay, again we will get a balance in this account, right? So what we have to do, this is the closing balance. It is given in the problem that, see, read the problem. It is given through current accounts, that is capital of E, capital adjustment has to be done through current account. Okay, so you can see here through current account. So idannu madid mele enadru capital adjustment madid mele still if there is balance, that has to be adjusted through current account. Current account mulaka adana adjust madbeku. So how do we do this? Now you have to balance the account. You have to see which side is more, debit or credit side. Now in the case of C, iga kevala C du account annu nodi, illi naavu debit side nodvaga 4,08,000, but you can see here the credit side is less, so you get debit side hechu untu. Amount is 4,08,000. Amount is 4,08,000. Next partner also debit side hechu untu avandralli sa, it is 4,08,000, okay. And the next partner there also, here it is 2,50,000, here it is 2,50,000 equal. So debit side is equal to credit side, 2,50,000, okay. So this is 2,50,000. Now we will go back to C's account. Just see C's column. Erdu side C the column annu nodi. Debit side it is 4,08,000 total. Okay, credit side is less, so we have to take the debit total. Debit total anne illi haakta idene. It is 4,08,000. Okay. Now you will get the balance. That is, when you have. I'll show the calculation here. Okay, so you have 4,08,000 debit total, 4,08,000. Okay, 4,08,000 minus 1,00,000 minus 25,000 minus 25,000. Ee moorannu now minus maarteve, minus 1,00,000 minus 25,000. And then once again minus 25,000. Okay, ali credit side ali more item itto, so you get this answer 2,58,000. This is the balance in their account. Okay, 2,58,000. So the balance in the account is 2,58,000, which has to be recorded as balance. Now this is done through current account. E balance annu current account ke haakbeku. So I will write it as by partner's current account. It is current account. Okay. So here we have to make it through C's current account. Okay. We have two partners. So C's current account 2,58,000. Now what about the other partner? In the other partner's account also, we have a total of 4,08,000. Okay, so we have 4,08,000 in the other partner. Okay, so this is what we have, 4,08,000. Now 4,08,000 minus 50,000 minus 25,000 minus 25,000, that is equal to ee mooru item annu minus maduvaga you get 3,08,000. Okay, 3,08,000. So 2,58,000 and 3,08,000 total will be equal 4,08,000 and 4,08,000. Then for a partner, new partner, we do not have to do anything. We because the debit total is equal to credit total. Okay. Now this 3,08,000, I will write it in the next line. 3,08,000 is the balance in D's account, okay, which will be adjusted through his current account. So it is by D's current account. D's current account. Okay. So we have done the capital adjustment. First, we need to calculate the final closing balance. ಮತ್ತೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾದರೂ ನಂತರ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಉಳಿದ್ರೆ ಅದನ್ನು ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಅಕೌಂಟಿಗೆ ನಾವು ಹಾಕಬೇಕಾಗ್ತದೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಹೌ ವಿ ಪ್ರಿಪೇರ್ ದ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್. ನೌ ಒನ್ಸ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ದ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಅಡ್ಜಸ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್. ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಡಿಡ್ ಇಸ್ ವಿ ಫಾಲೋಡ್ ದ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಆಸ್ಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಟು ಅಡ್ಜಸ್ಟ್ ದ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಡಿ ಅಕಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದ ನ್ಯೂ ಪ್ರಾಫಿಟ್ ಶೇರಿಂಗ್ ರೇಷೋ ಬೇಸ್ಡ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಇ ಥ್ರೂ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ we have taken the capital of E, that is 2 lakh. On that basis, we have found the total capital, 10 lakh. This 10 lakh is divided among the three partners. It is distributed among the three partners in their profit sharing ratio. So new profit sharing is ratio is 2:1. So we found C's capital of 4 lakh, D's capital is 4 lakh, and E's capital is, anyway, it is given, it is 2 lakh. Now, after getting this, we can verify this answer. See, if you reduce this, you'll get 4:4:2. Okay, so once again, it can be written as 2:2:1. So what we find is the capital is in the ratio of, in the profit sharing ratio. That is, the capital is in the new profit sharing ratio. So we have taken this as the closing balance. Now, after taking this as a closing balance, if we have any balance in the capital account alli innu balance bandre adannu avaru current account alli adjust maadi anta helidare. They have asked us to adjust it through current account. So we have a balance of 2,58,000 and 3,08,000, and that is debited to current account. Okay, so this is the way in which we have to prepare the capital account when there is capital adjustment. Next is cash account. In the cash account, we have a total of, in cash account we have a total of balance, opening balance of 56,000. Then there is cash receipt, that is capital contribution by E, which was credited to capital account. And initially, whatever that he brings in for goodwill, goodwill ige hana contribute madodannu now capital account ige hakideve. So this is total receipt is 2,50,000 here. Now the closing balance is 3,06,000. 56,000 modle iddadu nantra 2,50,000 receipt agide, 3,06,000. Now finally, we have to prepare the balance sheet of the new firm. Okay, after adjusting the revalued items, that is, first we have on the asset side stock value was 1,05,000. Then it is to be reduced by 5,000, so I have to deduct it. 5,000 minus martene illi 1 lakh bartade. Debt is 1,41,500. The bad debts, okay, which cannot be recovered, has to be written off. So 5,500 is the bad debt. If you deduct this minus, you will get the answer 1,36,000. Furniture opening balance was 7,500 here, which is to be reduced by 750. This 750 ano already now revaluation account alli takondideve. Okay, so it is debited to revaluation account. All these depreciation and the reduction in the value, it is already debited to revaluation account. So once again, you have to adjust the item in the balance sheet. Okay, you have to deduct it from the respective asset value, and closing final balance has to be written in the outer column. Investments, as it is, we have to take it. It is 10,000. Cash balance now it is 3,06,000. Okay, next is we have creditors on the liability side. It has not changed, so 70,000. Idda hage baruttave. Bills payable is 50,000. Outstanding repair bills. So we did not have it in the old balance sheet. Okay, this is an unrecorded liability. We have already recorded it in the revaluation account. So this unrecorded liability is brought into books of accounts, 4750. Now you have to record it in the balance sheet. You have to show this item in the balance sheet. It is a liability, so on the liability side, 4750. Now closing balance of capital is there in the capital account. This is the closing balance, 4 lakh, 4 lakh and 2 lakh. And then there is one more item, that is current account. Okay, now this current account, if you see the journal entry, it is current account debtor to capital account. So in both the cases, C and D, we have debited current account. So finally, there is a debit balance in the current account. So whenever we have a debit balance, it is to be recorded on the asset side. Okay, as for that matter, one important information on asset side, okay, all these accounts that are recorded on asset side will have a debit balance. So when current account has a debit balance, it has to be recorded on the asset side. If current account is credited, if it has a credit balance, then you have to write it on the liability side. Okay, so now ee case alli namge current account alli debit balance untu. Okay, yakandre now baradantaha entry neevu nodidre nimma capital account alli, it is current account debit to capital account. This is the entry, and when you do the posting to the current account, it will be debited to current account, and ultimately there is debit balance in the current account. So whenever there is a debit balance in the current account, you have to write it on the asset side. Okay, so I have taken now all the important items. Now we have to get the total, and we have the same total on the assets and liability side. Okay, so this is how we have to solve when we have capital adjustment in the partnership accounts, okay, in the admission of partner. Thank you.